talk to us about all these findings. I mean, there is a lot to go through. This is front and back for both the Senate and the House. So what are some of the key points and key takeaways that you notice from this report?
Right. I think that a lot of the things we saw through this report, we knew we would see because of COVID. We're seeing a lot of problems with reading and math and behavior, a lot of things that we haven't seen in the past with behavior and mental health. And that's mostly due to COVID. So, you know, I don't think we saw anything that was too shocking, but we've got a lot of work to do in education coming up in the next session for sure.
Now, you are a Democrat. There are two Democrats in the committee. Have you talked to your counterpart about some of the issues that you want to discuss in the committee when you return to Little Rock in January?
Well, we just found out this week that we got on the committee, so we have not had a chance. I've just gotten back from Little Rock working on orientation for the members-elect, and so we've spent last week doing that and choosing committees and that kind of thing. So we just, that's all based on seniority, and so we really didn't know who would be on which committee until this week. So we are just now really starting to think about what this session is going to look like. And we really have not heard anything concrete from the governor-elect or her team about you know, her expectations for education. So we've got a lot of work ahead, but we don't know enough yet really to know exactly what we'll be doing.
I know that some Republicans have been saying that they have been in touch with Governor-elect Sarah Huckabee Sanders talking about education. They want to put education first and, you know, kids first. Have you heard anything?
Well, you know, I've heard a lot of things, but I want to be able to sit down with her and with her chief of staff and with her education folks and really talk to them about their expectations. I did have an opportunity to spend some time with her chief of staff talking about early childhood, which I think is so important. Yes. And until we start talking about kids' development, brain development from 0 to 3 and 5, you know, 85% of your brain's developed by the time you're 3 years old. And we're not doing enough for infant and toddlers, and we really need to be doing more work in that early childhood development realm. And then preschool, certainly we need to work on preschool and make sure that everyone has access to preschool. Right now, only about half of our Arkansan children have access to preschool. So we want to make sure that that's the case. And I know that she is interested in that. You know, we're hearing lots of rumors about vouchers and private school and funds following the children and that kind of thing. And, you know, I don't know enough about her policy expectations to know whether that's true or not. You know, I really feel like we have got to make sure that we're supplementing the public schools and that we are making sure that every child has access to a quality education. However we do that, you know, I'm open to looking at new ways of doing those sorts of things. But I want to make sure that we have, that every child has access to a quality education, and that we make sure that we close those equity gaps. Right now, there's some big equity gaps. We are 34th in overall education for the state. We're 41st in fourth grade reading and 43rd in eighth grade math, which is when we test those things. And for our Arkansans of color, those data are worse. And so we've got to make sure that we're dealing with some of the equity gaps as well.
All right, we're going to talk a little bit more about the equity gaps in early childhood education and a few other issues coming up in just 2 minutes. Thank you so much, Representative. We'll be back.
Thank you.
We're back with Representative Denise Garner, a Democrat from Fayetteville, who will be on the Education Committee in Little Rock in the House of Representatives in January. And Representative, thank you. Let's continue our conversation about early childhood education and the equity gaps that you were talking about. Do you see a correlation between equity gaps and early childhood education?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay. Talk a little bit about that.
Absolutely. You know, Arkansas is very last in maternal infant and mortality for maternal infant, and we've got to deal with prenatal too, all the way up. And like I said before, 85% of your brain is developed by the time you're three, and that's physical and emotional, cognitive. Those things are being developed by that early age. And we're not spending enough time with parent information and making sure that the caregivers for those kids at that age are cared for. So we've got to make sure that the caregivers are cared for, that we have the early infant care that we need, early infant and toddler care that we need, and then continue that education and care through pre-K. 3 and 4 year olds, 4 and 5 year olds, then in kindergarten. And then we're seeing the data show that, you know, kids do a whole lot better in school. Behavior is better. They graduate more frequently. They read, they understand math so much better if we take care of those issues in early childhood. You know, if there is a silver bullet, I think it's taking care of the prenatal to five. Mm-hmm. And you know, we could take care of so many of our problems in the education realm and workforce services, the prison pipeline, our overcrowded prison system, and you know, provide an access to end to get out of poverty, to continue to make sure that the folks that are in that poverty cycle can get out. And we have way too many Arkansans that are stuck there.
Now, we know that public schools in Arkansas start at kindergarten. There are some pre-K programs. Do you think that pre-K 4 and pre-K 3 should be available to everyone in
Absolutely.
Arkansas? Should the state pay for it?
Yeah, absolutely. I think we should. We can pay now or pay later. And, for the children's well-being, for the family's well-being, and for Arkansas's well-being, we need to pay early. We need to make sure that we're taking care of early childhood for that pre-K, and that means investing in ABC, in early Head Start, in some of those programs that we know work. We have the data to show they work. And so, yes, absolutely, I feel like we need to be doing that now. And then we will, we will decrease the funding that we need in some of these other realms that we've talked about.
So is that something that you'll be pushing for this session?
Absolutely, absolutely. Most of my colleagues have heard my mantra before, but it's certainly, until we take care of 0 to 3, then we're putting Band-Aids on the problems for the rest of our issues. And they've heard that, and they will hear it again.
Now, do you think that education is getting enough money? We've heard some lawmakers say that schools are getting enough money. They're just not using it the way they should be.
You know, I think we do need to look at our funding formulas. I think it's way past time to look at some of the things that we weren't dealing with when those formulas were made. And, you know, we didn't have the mental health problems. We didn't have technology. We didn't have a lot of the things that transportation was a very different issue when the matrix was formed. Special ed, there's so many things that are so different from when we formulated those, the matrix and the funding, the ways we fund schools. So, yes, I do think we need to look at the funding. There may be some areas that we absolutely need to to increase the funding. But I do agree that there are probably some schools that could utilize their funding better in better ways.
All right, Representative Denise Garner, thank you so much for joining us.
And thank you.
Have a nice couple of weeks until session starts again.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate you. Thanks for joining us this week for 4029 News on the Record. As a reminder, the 94th General Assembly begins in Little Rock on January 9th. Then the next governor of the Natural State, Sarah Huckabee Sanders, will be sworn into office on January 10th. We want to know what issues are most important to you as the voter. Email us at ontherecord@4029tv.com and visit our website, 4029tv.com, for more political coverage. We'll see you next week, same place, same time, as we continue our conversations with area newsmakers.